we have a threefold primary responsibility. Number one, get people saved. Number two, get them baptized. Number three, get them registered to vote.
Our form of government came directly from the Bible.
You commit yourself to the principles of God and demand those parties and politicians align themselves with the eternal values in this world.
In 1979, I started to see the proliferation of TV ministries across television.
They said quite openly that they were out to demolish the separation of church and state. And we decided to challenge the religious rights view of America. What I knew best was television. And that's how People for the American Way began.
So maybe there's something wrong when people, even preachers, suggest that other people are good Christians or bad Christians, depending on their political views.
I'm Barbara Jordan. Recently, I watched a broadcast by the television evangelist, Pat Robertson, which appeared on hundreds of stations, including this station.
Welcome to I Love Liberty. Who am I? I'm an American.
I'm wearing the original 13 here.
Yeah. I remember Miss Betsy sitting there going,
"Ooh, this could be the start of something big." Ooh.
This is Gregory Peck. Robert Bork wants to be a Supreme Court justice, but the record shows that he has a strange idea of what justice is. Please urge your senators to vote against the Bork nomination, because if Robert Bork wins a seat on the Supreme Court, it will be for life, his life and yours.
The Robert Bork nomination ended today. The Senate voted by an overwhelming 58-42 margin to reject the controversial appointment.
I'm very pleased this morning to announce that Judge Bork has decided to join my campaign team.
The research group Right Wing Watch has been putting together sort of the collected works of the people who Rick Perry is doing this prayer event with.
People adrift in a sea of moral relativism. We need God's help. That's why I'm calling on Americans to pray and fast like Jesus did.
You know, we started this program, Young People For, because we were, quite frankly, sick and tired of being handed our nation's leadership. That we wanted to put our fingerprint on what the future leadership of this country, particularly progressive leadership, would look like.
I'm really interested in public health and community health and progressive health organizations.
Projects around immigrant communities, workers' rights,
LGBTQ and women's issues.
Hey fellows, we just finished the National Summit Training of Trainers.
People in this organization have a long history of protecting the rights of those whose position in society or whose pocketbook does not afford them the luxury of political influence.
Most people today who are protesting in different areas around the country, that we can take some credit for that. Because those people are empowered and those people are emboldened to do what they do because they live in a world where there is some source of truth and honesty and real information for them. And that's what People for the American Way is to me.
People have the power to dream, to rule, to wrestle the earth from the floor.
Because of recent political developments, I think that People for the American Way is more important than ever.